Today, I would like to touch on five main areas of personal finance. So first, I would like to talk about saving. What is that you must save your money before you spend it. When it comes to saving, it's very important to set a saving target. Okay, so the rule of thumb of saving for Malaysian, if you contribute to EPF, I would say on top of EPF, on behalf of the employer, you yourself, your own contribution plus your saving should combine to have about 30%. For those people who do not have EPF contribution, you should save about 35%. But if you want to really have a solid saving plan, it's very important for you to do a holistic financial plan to determine your optimum saving target, so that your saving is enough to achieve your maybe your children's tertiary education funding, your golden retirement lifestyle, or buy a dream home for yourself. Very importantly is that don't just save your money. Channel your saving straight to a regular saving plan of a good investment scheme. So next, we want to talk about review and improve investment strategies. Okay, and one of the important tips that we need to be aware of is that you need to find out what is the optimum return target so that you're able to achieve your financial goals with high certainty. To achieve something more certain, anything beyond 12%, it is really speculative. After setting a optimum return, we should invest into the investment of your money into the right kind of investment. When it comes to investing, very important, don't invest and forget. Okay. Depending on your own circumstances, you should get coverage on H&S, critical illness, total and permanent disability, and also death. When you plan for, say, total permanent disability and also death coverage, you must consider whatever wealth that you have already accumulated. So as a rule of thumb, I always suggest that don't spend more than 15% of your gross income on insurance coverage. You should consider also reducing your insurance premium slowly as you go right to your retirement years, because it's very painful and burdensome to pay insurance premium when you do not have active income. If you are serious about determining what should be the optimum coverage, what should be the optimum premium you should pay, speak again to your financial planner. Do tertiary education, especially overseas education, is very expensive. Without proper planning, without proper saving and accumulating funds, you may fail to provide the kind of tertiary education you want to provide for children, okay? So on the other hand, there is also a risk of overspending on one child's tertiary education and affect your other financial goals. So it's only fair for you to get a holistic financial plan done. Whatever plan for tertiary education, you must take into consideration of the timeline and cash flow, especially if you have got a few children and limited liquid resources. Make sure you choose the right vehicle. I believe this is also a good time for us to review our retirement planning. Okay, and let's face it, EPF alone will not be enough to fund your whatever retirement. Without a solid financial plan, you will not be able to make the right decision on when you should be retiring. If you are close to like 5 years to retire already, so very near to the D-Day already, so you should start planning for your specific retirement income sources.